Gentlemen, everybody, and welcome to this short talk, just a few minutes, on charcoal as an efficient energy for Brazil. Why talking about charcoal? Because charcoal is a real industry in Brazil. And why talking about Brazil? Because I spent 10 years in Brazil before to come here. So I think it was a good opportunity for me to share my experience in Brazil. So, when we talk about Brazil, what are the first impressions? This is Rio de Janeiro, beaches, dance, favela, etc., etc. But Brazil, not only these pictures. Brazil, we used to call Brazil a country continent because it's a big country. So let me give you a few numbers related to this country. So Brazil, this is the third world rank renewable energy. Very interesting. The fifth largest country in the world with more than 8 million of square kilometers. Just to give you an idea, it's around 15 times the size of France or of Thailand, around 2 to 15 times Thailand. And this is the sixth largest population in the world, with more than 200 million people. But Brazil, it is also the second largest forest land. You have to know the Brazilian forest represent more than 15% of the total forest in the world, mainly in Amazon region rainforest. And finally, Brazil is the first world rank in terms of water availability, natural water. So this point is very important because with this point, Brazil developed its energetic matrix using hydro electricity. Okay, so let me talk a little bit about the Brazilian biomass energy experience. So the gross domestic supply in Brazil, more than 40% of this energy comes from renewable energy, mainly from sugarcane, hydraulic, firewood and charcoal and others. And biomass represents more than 50% of this renewable energy. Who are energy users? Mainly industry and transport. And as you can read, industry and transport represent more than two-thirds of the total consumption of energy in Brazil. Now let me show you the ratio in terms of renewable energy between consumptions and users. So for industry, more than half of the energy consumed came from renewable energy. And the part of biomass in this energy is more than 30%. So you can see the role of biomass is very, very important in this country. For transport, 100% of the renewable energy come from biomass, mainly to produce power and biodiesel. And for domestic energy, biomass represents around 25%. So now you have a short idea about this country, this big country, and you can see how this country developed energy policy based on renewable energy and mainly with biomass. So now let me talk about the charcoal-based pig iron. So you have to know, most of the pig iron produced in Brazil use charcoal. Just to give you an idea, the price of the pig iron, 60% of the price of pig iron is the price of the charcoal. So you can understand why the chapel industry is very, very important in this country and why we did and we are doing and we do a lot of top research to improve chapel productions. So Brazil is the one third of the world's chapel production. In this small graph, you can see the blue line, this is the production in Brazil, and the green line, this is the production in Thailand, and the red one in France. So just one anecdote. In Brazil, they produce in one day the total production in one year in France. So you can see that this is another dimension. 90% of this production of the charcoal is destined to for pig iron and pure silicon. Why? Because they use charcoal to produce energy in the blast furnaces, but also charcoal is used as reductants. So this is the two main role of charcoal. The main problem in Brazil, 80% of this charcoal is produced with a traditional handcraft method. So that means not very efficient. So that's why we have to improve this technology. This is what I will show you just after. And this is another issue, another challenge. More than 50% of the wood produced charcoal come from native forests. So this is really a big issue in this country. So about plantation. So you can see in this graphic, plantation represents only 1% of the total area in Brazil. It's very low. And why? And what? For what we use plantations? Mainly eucalyptus. For mainly wood industry. And cellulose and paper. And finally, less than 50% for charcoal. Okay, so to produce pig iron, we have two main routes. The first one is to use coke as carbon source. And the second one is to use charcoal. So the routes are exactly the same. Just blast furnaces has a big difference, because if you use coke, the mechanical properties are stronger than charcoal. So you can use bigger blast furnaces. For charcoal, you have to use smaller blast furnaces. But why there is two routes? Because a few years ago, the Brazilian government decided to reduce CO2 emissions. And the production of pig iron is one of the most the bigger emission of CO2 in Brazil. So this graphic is very, very interesting. The stick are the production of charcoal in million of tons. The red one are charcoal from native forest, and the yellow one, charcoal from plantations. And you can see, in 2000 decade, we started to reverse the proportion of native forest as a raw material and plantation. And you can see the cube, the blue one is the percentage of native wood to produce charcoal. And from the beginning of 2000, this proportion, this ratio increased to reach more than 50%. So that means today, when you produce charcoal with two wood, one came from the forest native, from the rainforest, and the other one from the plantation. After a drop of this consumption, why? Because in 2008, the crisis. So pig iron consumption decreased, so the country needed less charcoal to produce pig iron. But now, during 5 years, we have a stabilization of this forest native as a raw material to produce charcoal. And now, the last numbers show this number is increasing again. So the question is, what can we do? First, to improve the quality of charcoal, to improve the production of charcoal, and to reduce the pressure on forest native. To know that, let me show you the flowchart production of pig iron. As you can see, the first step is to select the material, the good wood to produce charcoal. And finally, you produce sealing, you break, you cut, you transport, you transform in charcoal, and finally you get your charcoal. This is the global flowchart to produce charcoal. So the question was, with my colleagues from different laboratories, where we can investigate to improve the quality of charcoal and reduce the pressure on rainforest. So we try to finally to work only on more efficient technologies. For that, we have new new philosophy in terms of research. We try to innovate, to find new process, new technologies. So this is what I'm going to show you right now. And what is very important, because you will see how in this country, research and laboratory is very close from the private company, from the private sector. So all research we need to improve the private sector with a big company. So the challenge is how to go from this traditional technology to produce charcoal. This was the same in Thailand, you know, to the big kiln like that. It was our challenge. Sorry. So we worked on these five topics during 10 years. And improving these different topics, we improved our, I said already, the charcoal production and the quality of the charcoal. So let me show you. The first one is written differently in Italy, boiler productivity, because this is not my area. But let me just show you what they did, other colleagues from CIRAD. They increase the productivity of eucalyptus from 9 to more than 70 cubic meter per guy per year in 30 years, just selecting the good planting. So I think this one is very, very good. Now we stabilize this production. Okay, so the first one, the first topic was, the first challenge was to scale up the technology. So the basic kiln you can meet in Brazil are more or less 100 cubic meter. So it's already a big kiln, 100 cubic meter. And we decide to improve, to limit the cost, you know. So every year we increase, and finally we get 800 cubic meter. So I don't know if you can represent, but it's very, very huge. Just to give you an idea, to do one process of our life with charcoal, it takes more than 1 month. 1 month. So what we did at laboratory scale, we worked mainly on heat transfer in the kiln, and after we tried to scale. We try to design new reactor like this one. So this first topic was the first improvement. Second one, we try to mechanize all the process to avoid manpower. So you can see in the loading, this is a small kiln, and you can see a big truck can go inside. Another thing very important, why? These kilns are rectangular because we adapt directly the kiln to the wood. Plantations are put around 10 meters. We cut in the middle and we put directly in the oven. So we adapt the kiln to the shape of the biomass. So you can see in each step, all is mechanized until the shipment, the final shipment. So towards the second topic, we have tried to improve. The third one, this is the control of paralysis phases. So we develop models in the laboratory to know how different phases occur during the paralysis. So I mean drying, torrefaction, paralysis, and cooling. And after, we try to adapt this model to the reality. So this is what we did using different tools to know exactly how are different temperatures inside the cube. So it was the first topic. The fourth, and the one I think the most important is the cooling system. Why? Because when I say, for example, for a big furnace, you need 1 month to produce charcoal after you fill the kiln, close the door, and you have to wait 1 month to produce charcoal. And the cooling phase is more than one third of this phase. I mean, in 1 month, 10 days are necessary just for cooling the kiln. So if you reduce the cooling phase, you will improve the economic efficiency of this kiln. Because why? If you have to wait the cooling, you cannot use this kiln to produce more charcoal. So that's why you have rapidly to recover charcoal. So we work a lot on this topic. The first one was very simple, you know, just sprinkle water and a mix of water and dust like mud to reduce temperature. Afterwards, we developed a natural convection exchanger using the pound gas from the kiln. Here, exchanger half, and after the gas go back to the furnace. So we reduce by 15% the time to cool charcoal. After we improve with another exchanger per liquid, so we improve the efficiency. And finally, we use a fourth air exchanger. So we again improve the cooling phase. This game shows you how works the cooling system. It's very easy. You have the gas from the paralysis. Here the gas, there is an exchange with the air from outside, and this gas is re-injected in the kiln. The challenge was to don't inject air in the kiln, because if you inject air in the kiln, you have combustion and you lost all your production. Now, during paralysis, you produce a lot of other gas, very, very rich gas you can burn. So we work a lot to develop small burners at the laboratory scale. And after, we transfer this technology to the big industry. So we develop very big burners to recover this energy from paralysis. And let me show you, this graphic is very interesting because we also work on the logistics to avoid, to make more efficiency, heat recovery, production of gas recovery and production of heat. So the first plant was rectangular, if you want, this linear position. Now the new one, all the kiln are in a circular position. Why? That one is better than that one. Because you reduce distance from here to here, for example. So you avoid condensation and you keep energy. So that one was also another topic we improved during these 10 years. Now, we produce gas, we burn gas. How to use this gas? So when you produce for all thermochemical processing, the most important when you use biomass, is to use dry biomass. Very, very important, you know. So, how we get a lot of energy from our lighties? We decide to use this energy for drying. I just a few words to explain. When you produce charcoal, you know, it's very simple. You have an amount of wood. You put this wood in a kiln. You burn part of this wood, and the energy from this wood will transform the other part of the wood in charcoal. So we call that partial combustion. If you get many, many waters in the biomass, you need this energy to dry, to remove water. So you lost energy to produce charcoal. So that's why drying wood is very important. So as you can see, we did something very, very simple. The gas from the combustor, we just imagine some tubes and to recover heat from the burner and inject directly on the wood. And just show you, that one is a dryer, very simple dryer with a plastic round just to keep heat inside. So this is what we try to develop also to improve drying system. And recently we built different kind of dryers. So now just to finish, I said we produce gas, we use this gas for drying, but also we can use this gas to produce electricity. So this one is a French technology we developed in Brazil. Now it was in Brazil, in Germany, in France, and they are transferring this technology in Canada. This is a new technology, and let me just show you. In the middle, you have a carbonization process. All is monitored by computer. From these small metallic kilns, you produce charcoal here, and you produce gas. This gas goes to a steam turbine. You can produce more than 3 megawatt electric, and part of the gas goes to the dryer here. And after drying, the biomass come back to the carbonization process. So this scheme exists for metallic process, metallic kilns. I mean more mature technology. You know, it's quite expensive. But just to finish, let me show you this now Russian technology. Let's say the ideal for us charcoal plant. So we can find here all the topics, all the challenge I just show you. I mean dryers, gas from combustion, transport of the wood, transport of charcoal mechanized, high capacity kilns, improvement of the cooling system, and production of electricity. So today this is what we are trying to develop, and every year I used to spend around 3 weeks in Brazil. This is to work on this program. So thank you very much. Just this small video to show you how CO2 and temperature are increasing. This is very simple. Okay, thank you very much.
I just wonder, did you calculate
chain production or just biologist process?
Making the charcoal first synthetic.
Yes, yes, of course, yes. That's why we develop cogeneration, you know, to produce energy, electricity. Because when you produce charcoal, you have an excess gas, huge excess of gas. So the energy balance is positive. And that's why we lost more than 70% of energy during the charcoal production. So we try to keep this energy for another use. So that's why we develop burners, we develop drying, we develop cogeneration. But we did, of course. Every time, for every technology, we develop mass balance and energy technique. You mean to produce pig iron with refined wood?
Yeah.
Yes. Just to explain, to produce pig iron, you know, this is iron oxide. And you have to remove oxygen, so that's why we need carbon for that. And we work with firewood, we work with qualified wood, and finally with charcoal. Charcoal is the best way to produce pig iron. Why? Because biomass has a less content in sulfur. Coke, not the case. So that's why all pig iron industry prefer to use biomass than coke. But they don't use firewood, no more. And you know, you use also charcoal to produce silicon for PV. You use charcoal to do the same.
But the charcoal also act as detonation.
Yes, it is, yes, of course. It has two main roles during the pig iron production: energy and the reductant. Of course, yes. And you can mix. You can mix charcoal and coke. Green pig iron. This is, I think, more market Thank you.